गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट न्यू टॉपिक सल्फर प्रिंटिंग। सल्फर प्रिंटिंग इज यूज टू डिटेक्ट सल्फर इन स्टील। इट इज ऑल्सो यूज परमानेंट रिकॉर्ड ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ सल्फर इन द स्टील। सल्फर मेक्स द स्टील कोल्ड शॉर्ट एज वेल एज हॉट शॉर्ट एंड हेंस detrimental to the properties of the steel. The harmful effect of sulfur is reduced by addition of manganese, and hence depending upon the amount of manganese, sulfur may exist as FeS, MnS or FeS plus MnS. The surface of component to be tested for distribution of sulfur should be fairly smooth and free from grease and scale. Polishing of surface on number 0 or 00 energy paper and subsequent thorough washing is enough for satisfactory result. Sulfur printing. The procedure is, first, the photographic bromide paper is soaked for about 3 to 4 minutes in 2% aqueous solution of H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid. The paper is taken from solution and excess solution is removed. The emulsion side of paper is placed in control with surface of specimen from about 2 to 3 mm under moderate pressure. The photographic paper is removed from the surface of the specimen, washed in clear running water and fixed permanently by keeping in photographic fixer solution for about 15 minutes. It is then taken out from solution, washed in running water of about 1 hour and subsequently dried by an appropriate method. Examination of this print is curiously reveals the presence of sulfur by dark color areas of silver sulfide on the paper. The grounding of such dark spot all areas indicates the presence of sulfur segregation, whereas a random dispersion of the spots denotes a more uniform and less harmful distribution of sulfur. The precautions taken during the sulfur printing. A paper type of photographic paper with regards to surface finish must be used. A semi-matic paper is good because of its less tendency of slippage on the specimen surface. The paper should be in complete contact with the specimen surface and all the entrapped air bubbles between the paper and specimen surface should be removed carefully, pressing with a squeegee roller. The contact time of photographic paper on surface specimen must be controlled properly. The micro areas of FeS and MnS gets enlarged by 200 to 300 times are revealed on printing paper as dark areas of Ag2S. The size of these areas will increase further with more time and may lead to erroneous interpretation. The reactions are as follows. FeS from steel plus H2SO4 from paper is equal to FeSO4 and H2S, and MnS from steel plus H2SO4 from paper is MnSO4 plus H2S. Again, H2S plus twice AgBr emulsion on paper gives Ag2S plus twice HBr. This Ag2S is brown in color. The entire process of sulfur printing can be carried out in daylight. Let's flow line observation. It is well known that forged components have superior properties than cast or roll and machine component. Also, the properties of forged components are governed by the metal flow patterns, means how the metal flow into the specific shape. Therefore, it is necessary to find out whether the component is manufactured by forging or casting or rolling and machining. This is achieved by macro etching. The prepared surface of the component in a 50% aqueous solution of hydrochloric acid at a temperature of 60 to 70 degree Celsius for about 5 to 10 minutes. If the component is forged, micro each surface shows a directional flow pattern consisting of streak and striation. The orientation of this pattern with respect to the plane of prepared surface indicates the direction of metal flow during the forging. The flow lines are seen because the elongated inclusions and other elongated heterogeneous areas are selectively attacked by etching reagent. Even after normalizing and annealing of the component, flow lines are seen. This is due to the presence of elongated non-metallic inclusions. Non-metallic inclusions do not recrystallize during the normalizing and annealing. And the second, the presence of prepared orientation areas which are always formed due to normalizing or annealing of cold work metal. Appearance of flow line on macro etch surface is an indication of mechanical working and not an indication of defect. Forged component show flow lines and they follow streamlined path as shown in figure A, which we will say next. Cast components do not show flow lines. Roll and machine component show broken and discontinuous flow lines. A typical photo macrograph of socket tuition show flow lines in figure. We will see this figure one by one. This is the flow line observation. Photo macrograph showing flow lines in longitudinal section of the forge hoop. This is the appearance of flow lines in a tearing block manufactured by forging. This is the flow line. This is appearance of flow lines in a bearing block manufactured from a roll by machining. Means these flow lines are deferred. And this is the hoop where the flow lines is like this. This is spark test.